Morning, everybody. Morning, everybody. Morning, everybody. Starting to wake up. Some of you are starting to wake up. That's good. That's good. That's good. That's good. Yes. Yes, yes. A couple announcements before we get started tonight. Today, I'm already in tonight. Let me tell you something. If you missed last night, you missed last night. Clark, is this on? God, my Savior. Okay, we had Holy Ghost Church here last night. Man, the March of the Misfits. Now, Brother Lewis said he's going to continue that today. I hope that he does, because it was very timely. On the back of the bulletin, don't forget our prayer needs and prayer requests there. Also, Dream Team for today and Dream Team for next Sunday is on that bulletin. Thank you, Dream Team, for all that you do and being prompt and ready to go. Don't forget that tonight also is church at 6 o'clock, okay? 6 o'clock tonight, we have church. We were out last night by 8:30 or 9, so you got time to get home and get your beauty sleep. You know, somebody said one time, I need to go home and get my beauty sleep. And the guy looked at him and said, well, you just need to pray for a coma. Amen. So, some of you got that. And then church Monday night at 7 and Wednesday night at 7 and Saturday night next weekend, 6 o'clock. And then two services next Sunday. Also, if you would like to give to help Sister Kim Beck at IBC, we're still receiving money in for that. So just place it in the offering today. We're going to put that toward her school bill. And then Tuesday, October 4th, everybody say October 4th. Tuesday is a Prophet Tom. Prophet Tom will be here Tuesday, October 4th, so don't forget that. Horizons is selling butter braids. All proceeds are going toward the new floor in the fellowship hall. And then there's a new FWC podcast. You can go to iTunes, to Vandalia Family Worship Center, and tap into the podcast. That will be the sermons that are going on now, or will be on the podcast. So we want to just be a 21st century church. Amen? Amen. I'm trying to be 21st century, but I don't understand Snapchat, Instagram, and all that. I have people who send me Snapchats, but they're not for me. They're for Macy. So then I try to scan them and see what they are, but I don't know how to open them or anything like that. But I'm working on that. I'm going that way. Amen. Also, if you would like to try online giving, we have set up a plan where you can give online from your cell phone, from your bank account, okay, right through the internet. I have instructions up here on how to do it. We'll try it to see if it'll work. They're right here. See me after church, and I'll give you some of those instructions as well. And WJLY is having their fall share-a-thon here this coming week, and they would like for Family Worship Center to cook or bake 10 dozen cookies. So can I get some volunteers? Is that you, Pastor Rob, back there? Look at him back there. Yes. Yes, brought the good word of the Lord Wednesday night. Amen. Talking about pride. Amen. Sister Donna. Hello, Sister Donna. How are you doing? Amen. So, can I get volunteers for cookies right now? I need 10 dozen cookies. Who you are and who are you? Sister Kay, how many are you making? Kay Jones is making 5 dozen. All right, who else? All right, Christy, how many are you making? 3. Catherine, how many? Catherine, do you not have enough to do already? You going to make 3? All right, that gives me 11 dozen. Dan, 2 dozen. All right. Brandon, are you cooking them or is Lauren cooking them? No Walmart. Hey, we want these to be homegrown, all right? Homegrown, okay? Amen. Okay, anybody, I know I don't want to offend anybody. Susan, you want to do some too? How many you want to make? 2 dozen? All right. Bella wants to do 2? All right, Bella. She's sewing into that radio station up there. Amen. Okay. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 19 dozen. I think that'll be... Geneva, you want to do 2 dozen? All right. Okay, we'll get these delivered. How about that? I'll find out when they need to be delivered, and we'll get those delivered. Might need somebody to volunteer to take them there to Ramsey to the radio station. Thank you for that. Hey, let's give the Lord some hand praising for all of that. And don't forget, we're going to be webcasting, and we'll have CDs available if you'd like CDs of Brother Lewis's sermons and the services here. And we were able to put another block up on the building this past week. Amen. Look, close $30,000 toward our new gym. Are you ready to worship the Lord? Anybody ready to give the Lord some praise and some worship and adoration? This front area is open. Why don't we come celebrate Jesus right now? Amen.
Every praise is to our God, in every word of worship with one accord. Every praise, every praise is to our God. Sing hallelujah to our God, in glory hallelujah is to our God.
Every praise is to our God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. When we call your name, you answer us. You hear our cry, Jesus.
God Almighty, and Ancient of Days, and Giver of Faith, and Lord, I need you. And Lord, you reply, 'cause you bring your kingdom to stand by my side. And Giver of life, you're all that I need. Father, you're everything that's precious to me. There is no one like you, Lord.
Thank you. Now fade away, and every crown
and heaven is trembling in all of your wonders. The kings and their kingdoms are standing amazed, and hearing your presence, we are undone. And hearing of joy, and every fear suddenly wiped away. 'Cause here in your presence, and all of my gains now fade away. Every crown no longer on display.
And beautiful.
and every way wonderful, beautiful, glorious, matchless in every way wonderful, beautiful, glorious, matchless in every way wonderful, beautiful, glorious, matchless in every way.
Just reach your hands up toward heaven right now. Just close your eyes. Reach your hands toward heaven. Invite that wonderful, beautiful, matchless, glorious power of the Lord in your life today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you today. We open up our hearts and our lives to you today, Jesus. Your presence is in this room in such a beautiful, powerful way, God. So, Lord, we seek you because the word says that if we seek you, we'll find you. And if we're looking for you, then you're looking for us. And you're going to find us, Lord, and meet every need in the name of Jesus. God, we have needs. We have decisions that we have to make. We have circumstances and situations that we're facing. But Lord, today we stand in the presence of wonderful. Today we stand in the presence of beautiful and glorious. Oh, Lord, we love you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And the prophet dipped his potent pen of prophecy in the inkwell of inspiration as the Holy Spirit moved on him and he began to write, "For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace." And the angel appeared to Joseph that night and said to him, "Fear not, Joseph, to take unto thee Mary for thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, and she shall bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins." Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So 2,000 years later, I gotta say, wonderful. Beautiful, glorious,
matchless in every way, wonderful, beautiful, glorious, matchless in every way.
give him some praise now, would you do it? Would you give him some ovation, applause, recognition, honor, hallelujah. Oh, thou shalt bring forth a son and shall call his name Jesus. Somebody say that name today. Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
King of majesty, there is no power in hell or any who can stand. And before the power and the presence of the great I am, the great
God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Jesus said before Abraham was, I am. Hallelujah. Revelation, John fell on his face, scared to death. Fear not, John, for I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. I am Alpha and Omega. The beginning and the end, the first and the last, the one which was and is to come. Hallelujah, the Almighty. Somebody give that Almighty God some praise today. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, we praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to give to the Lord today. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to sing and we're going to bring it. We're going to bring it saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, water baptized, right? So we're going to sing. You go back and get your gift and bring it to the Lord today in Jesus' name. Here we go.
One, two, and hallelujah, and holy, holy, God Almighty, the great I am, who is worthy.
The mention of your name,
King of majesty, there is no power in hell or any who can stand. And before the power and the presence of the great I am, 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 the great I am. And hallelujah, holy, holy, God Almighty, the great I am, who is worthy, none beside thee, God Almighty, the great I am, the great I am.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, God is great and greatly to be praised. You know, the Lord is concerned about every part of our lives. Amen. Every part of our lives. He cares for the greatest. He cares for the smallest. He died for everybody. Amen. Michelle just handed me a report card here from Jamie. There's about 12 to 15 different areas of grading here. And all but two of them are 100%. Amen. Isn't that awesome? That's awesome. That's awesome. She just said that the two these lacking is just because of attendance. Amen. God's doing it. God's doing a great work. Amen. Amen. What a wonderful presence of the Lord is in this place. I'm getting ready to turn this up, Brother Lewis. I want Brother Lewis to feel his liberty. I don't want him to, at straight up noon, he has to stop. I don't want him to feel that. He can go past noon. That gives the Baptist and the Methodist time to clear out the restaurants. Amen. We can come on in and clean it on up. Amen. So we're here for some Holy Ghost supper right now. We're here for some Holy Ghost fire. I want the Holy Ghost to tell me what's going on in my life. And if you were not here last night, I'm going to reiterate this. If he begins to pray for people in specific manners and matters, it's because God is telling him. I don't have time to tell him all your business. Because I don't want to know all your business. Your business pulls me down. I have enough trouble keeping my business afloat. Amen? So we're going to let the Holy Ghost just flow and move in this place. There are classes today from nursery to 11, right? Sister Amy just told me that. So we have Sunday school classes for the kids today, nursery through 11. Amen. So without any further ado, Brother Clark, all right. Would you stand with me in honor of the man of God, and let's just welcome the man of God and thank the Lord for his servant today. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, I thank you, Lord. You're so good, Lord. Songs being sung about how glorious He is the best of our humanity expressing the inexpressible. When you think, I know you're standing, just give me a brief second here. When you think of God, the Bible said He filleth all space. The entire solar system is inside of Him. He is so massive until your mind cannot even calculate. And yet, He loves so much that He can reduce Himself to the size of being able to set on the head of a stick pin to come down to my level. He's worthy. He's my breath. He's my being. He is everything that causeth me to function. And we praise Him. I said, and we praise Him. You can be seated. I want to give honor to Pastor and First Lady. I thank them for their kindness to me. It's a choice. They have the choice. It's not an entitlement that I stand behind this sacred desk. And I thank them for their confidence and trust. I really do. I said last evening about this series of the authority of the saints, and when I opened it, there was nothing there. So I went back to the evangelistic quarters, and what do you know? I found something. There's three set sermons. He sat down so I could stand up. The authority in the name. Casting down imaginations. You can have this. $20. You can plug them in your CD player going to work, and you at the same time you can enjoy the word of the Lord into your spirit. And we, in the hour we live, I was preaching here last night, soldier, and while I'm preaching here at about 8:30, bombs started going off in New York. Yes, the second bomb I read this morning was a pressure cooker bomb. And the news print said ISIS is celebrating right now. We are living not in the last day, but we're living in the last minutes. I don't mean to make you uncomfortable, but I will tell you, if your mindset is to live your life on autopilot and never do anything for the kingdom but just coast along, you hear what I'm telling you, your chances of making it are very scarce. We do not hear enough conviction preaching because we're living in an era in religiosity when people want their ears tickled. Mark Twain said, I believe it, that's his name. Is that right? Did I say that right? Mark Twain. Yeah, I knew I was wrong. Mark Twain said, the only thing that likes change is a baby. We don't like change. We like to operate within the structure of our personal design. We've got to be apt to change, understanding that God in His Word will never change. But we have to change being conformed to Him and His will and His purpose. You have to discover what is your purpose for being here. I don't mean to belabor. I want to get into the Word, but I want to say this. It doesn't matter what year or what time you were born. It doesn't even matter what date or time you die. When you go to the cemetery, you will see these grave markers, and it will have a time of birth, and it will have a year of death. It doesn't matter between birth and death. What matters is that dash between birth and death that matters. What did I do with myself between birth and death? That is what is going to count when we stand in the judgment seat of God. And as sure as I stand here, you hear me and you hear me well. Eternity never stops. Never stops. And do not let ministries, do not let friends or anybody else teach you that God is not a God of judgment. He is. I said He is. And we give an account of what not we do for our own life and our own sphere, but we give an account of what we did that He assigned us to do. That will be the judgment. What we did with our personal assignment. Did we accomplish it? That is what matters. You're not going to hang on to mama's coattail off of her prayers and her dedication and say, whoo, I made it by the skin of my chinny chin chin. Why would anybody want to live just on the borderline of being overdosed by flesh and just barely being able to make it? It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. It's full force. I die for this or I don't. I'm in this thing and I know what my parameters are. And I have to work on that. And there's so much going on. I got to get going here. But I want to do two things. Brother Sound Man, if you'll kick me up on the scripture I gave you, Exodus 17, 11, and 12. Pastor, I want to finish up the word that God gave me for you and your wife. And it came to pass when Moses held up his hand that Israel prevailed. When he held up his hand, Israel prevailed. Hallelujah. We are the spiritual Israel. This church prevails. And when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. So I segue to finish that word, and you can give it to the rest of it to your wife. In my prayers, you are a human being made up of the same gook that all of us are made up of. And that is pure dirt. There's nothing righteous about our flesh. That's why I don't understand why people invest so much in their flesh. Because it stinks and it decays and it rots. The only thing that is going to live is that soul. And when the trump of God sounds, the dead in Christ shall be caught up to meet him, not in heaven, but in the air. There's a difference. Hallelujah. And they which are alive and remain will be joined with them. We put on, hallelujah, immortality. No more decay. No more. This should give you an incentive to want to fight and push for the prize of the high calling of God. This world, this surrounding is not what this is all about. So you have to discover why and what is going on. Who is your enemy? It's not flesh and blood. It's not each other. Hallelujah. But I saw, that's not bad. That's just showing your humanity. We, even the prophets of old, Pastor, went in depression after they released the supernatural of God. And the reason for that is because when deliverance is released out of one's vessel, it leaves them feeling lonely. Jesus hanging on the cross, he said, "Father, Father, why hast thou forsaken me?" Other words, why has the spirit lifted out of flesh? You take the spirit of God out of the flesh of Jesus Christ and you have all of us. Hallelujah. His flesh was not divine. His spirit was divine. Oh, Lord, I love what I'm feeling. But when you hurt long enough and you suffer loss long enough and you walk in pain long enough, it should adjust one's attitude. It should adjust one's priorities. That there are more things in the kingdom of God that are more important than where I'm at right now and where I'm fighting now. I saw you. Your shoulders were slumped. Your hands were down. Been there? God said, but Moses' hands were heavy. They took a stone, put it under him, and he sat thereon. And Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands. The ones on one side, the other on the other side. And his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. As long as his hands were up, regardless of what was going on, it was a sign to the rest of them, we're winning. When Moses didn't feel like we're winning, we're winning. We're winning. Retreat is not an option. We're winning. If there's not but three of us holding your hands up, congregating in this assembly, we're winning. We're winning. We're winning in this community. We're winning in this city. If there's four of us that are committed, we're winning. We're winning because the pastor's hands. Thank you, brother. Thank you so much. I'm going to gloss real quick my text. 1 Samuel, if you'll stand in honor of the reading of the word. 1 Samuel 22 and 2. And everyone who was in, listen, distress. We don't know anything about that, do we? That's alien to us. Everyone who was in debt. We don't know anything about that either. And everyone who was discontented. Don't know about that. Gathered to him. So he became. Look at your neighbor and say, you must. Oh man, oh Jesus, help me. Look at your neighbor, open up your pie hole, and say, you must have a pastor. Look at him again. Say, you'll never succeed going rogue. So he became captain over them. And there were about 400 men with him. Take that as those that were here last night. The march of the misfits. I am, as I said last night, I am a card-carrying, proud misfit. Just like I'm a proud card-carrying NRA. I believe in my Second Amendment rights. Hallelujah. I am a card-carrying misfit. And God works supernaturally through misfits. Take 30 seconds if you think he deserves it from you personally. Raise your hands and you praise him the way you think he deserves it. Hey! Lord, it is in your name. It is in your word. And it is through your blood that I take authority over every spirit of distraction in this sanctuary right now. We must be focused, Lord. Our attention must be captured. Hallelujah. 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 The great I am. The great I am. The great I am. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. You can be seated. I'm real quickly going to gloss over what we covered last evening to give those an insight that was not able to be here. The term that describes most of us is misfit. We just don't fit in anywhere. The two definitions of misfit are something of the wrong size or shape for its purpose. One who is unable to adjust to one's environment or circumstances. Misfits are overlooked. The good news is that if you are a misfit, you are in great company. Winston Churchill seemed so dull as youth that his father thought he may be incapable of earning a living in England. Charles Darwin did so poorly in school that his father once told him, you will be a disgrace to yourself and to all your family. Thomas Edison, first teacher, described him as addled. And his father almost convinced him he was a dunce. Albert Einstein, his parents feared their child was dull, and he performed so badly in all high school courses except mathematics that a teacher asked him to drop out. Misfits, every one of them. The landscape of Scripture is riddled with misfits. One writer describes David's men, 400 misfits. They knew not well what to do with themselves. They were described as distressed, in debt, discontented. Not the type of information you want on a resume or your biography. Discontent means a restless desire of craving for something one does not have. Dissatisfied, displeased. In the Hebrew word, it literally means bitterness, or to have been wronged or mistreated. You may be bitter, or you may have been done wrong or mistreated. The issue, ladies and gentlemen, is how do you take this group of misfits who are broken, busted, and disgusted and turn them into a mighty fighting force? God and his purpose for this assembly is not for the sheep to go rogue, not to be scattered in thought, have personal agenda, personal goals that are against anything else, and try to come and combat the forces of hell that are working in this community. It'll never happen. It throws the church off into unhealthiness. God, when he made the garden, when he created it, it was a utopia. Like the gardens that you could go and see in Florida, it would make those gardens look like child's play. It was a utopia that was breathtaking. And when man allowed its flesh to be distracted by thought, we have been in trouble ever since. We are decayed. We are sick. We are in debt. We are displaced. We are overlooked. We are emotional wrecks. We simply are misfits. Hallelujah. Somebody talk to me. Somebody feed me back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's like saying words and they're not coming back in the monitor, so to speak. Hallelujah. Holler ouch or Honolulu or amen, but let me know your flesh is still alive out there. Glory. I said glory. You say, well, my God, I don't know. I'm feeling something. That's what I'm talking about. You should be able, and it's God's purpose that you should feel that reverence on your job in the morning. Hallelujah. In the schools, teenagers, you should feel that. That's the way God, brother, designed us. He designed us, and he does not make junk. He designed us for optimal performance. He made us to be kingdom minded. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. You cannot live so far in your past to when you get to your future, it's already gone. God did not design you to be wishy-washy. Have one decision one moment, can't stand on it, and I'm making another decision because I want to be comfortable. You hear me? There is no comfort. That uncomfortableness, the Spirit says right now, is an ability to be sensitized to the voice of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's trying to segue you from personal stress to that anxiousness because you feel him speaking. You feel him driving you into your purpose. Job's wealth. We hear a lot about wealth. And instead of getting behind why Job was wealthy, we want to market that, get an edge on that. It's like diet pills. Everybody, one guy gets it, he gets a patent on it. It ain't long and somebody is parroting that same diet pill and it begins to just go by the masses. And God's word has produced wealth. And they get an edge on it. They market that. They sell that behind the pulpits and podiums on television programs. And they're making a killing getting an edge on a success plan because everybody's uncomfortable. Everybody. They're just wanting a shot to get me over. Give me a fix. What you don't understand is that restlessness is God's spirit toying, dealing with your human spirit that he will not override. I can cast balls out of a drug addict, an alcoholic, but you can fast till your belly button sticks to your spine. You're never going to set a human spirit free. It has to be laid down. Your nature will never change until you sacrifice your own human spirit. Until you crucified. Oh, let me just give you some helpers right here. Did ever dawn on you why Jesus, he came in flesh in the shape of a cross? It's called laminin. He could have made us. He could have made Adam and Eve like an octopus. You could have arms and legs going everywhere. It's his design. It's his plan. Come on. Come on. You say, I'm listening. Yeah? Well, we can chew gum and walk at the same time. We can hallelujah. Man, that's good. Man, that's good. Wow. Whoa, that's good. That's good. That's good. Whoa, write some notes down. Woo! And you can draw from that on the oncoming days and say, I've done heard how I can deal with this spirit. But if it's going in one ear and out the other, and you're already thinking about what you're going to eat after a while, brother, you are a day late and a dollar short. You're still in the flesh, and you still got a problem. You are just a typical misfit that needs to be directed, that needs to come together, that needs structure. Some people cannot live for God without structure. Some want to be told, give me some laws, because my flesh is lawless. It's always gravitating to filth. Oh, Smiley's liking it, and aren't you there on the second row right there? She looks like Jimmy Carter. She just ain't got the peanuts between your teeth as far as I can see. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's good for you. Good for you. Laughter. Laughter. A smile. It's not stressful. It sends off enzymes, hormones through your brain, your memory center, and it dispatches healings to all sorts of places in your body. Have you ever got to laughing until you're laid on your side and you're crying and tears are rolling down your eyes? And when you finally gain control of yourself, you just feel like a cleansing has come. That's God. He's still up there. He's still alive. He's trying to prove to you my word, every line, hallelujah, every T crossed, every I dotted. I will not lie. I will not go back on my word. When you walk in obedience to my word, a day of obedience is a day of healing. A day of disobedience is a day of setback. Oh, hallelujah. He said, casting down imaginations, get your thought process, gather it up, lay it on the altar, and say, you made me for optimal performance, the march of the misfits. I have some living to do. I have an assignment on my life. And when you will learn to walk in your assignment, you won't have time to worry. You won't have time to be angry. You won't have time to pitch your hissy fits. You won't have time to yell at your husband. You won't have time to yell at your wife. Some of you are going to walk out of here hopping with one toe in your hand. Oh, God, he just danced all over my toe. Ooh, that bad boy is sore. I'm trying to show you that people you're fighting, and constantly with your chops, you're putting their flesh between your teeth because you think the scripture's talking about them being your enemy. Because they're demonized and they don't even know sometimes the way they're being used in their flesh. They don't know the offensive words they're saying. They don't know the hurt they're causing. They don't know the pain they're causing. So we level off at them. You who I'm going to pray about, that God brings you down and he exalts my reputation. Because flesh always wants to be right. If flesh would have been right, then Jesus could have stopped his mission hanging on that cross. He could have called down so many innumerable angels and killed every one of them and looked and said, now who's your daddy now? Come pay homage to me. He's not talking about a fleshly war. He's talking about a spiritual war that gets into people's flesh. And the reason it's in their flesh is because they refuse to submit their will, but they'll go to church and talk in tongues for a few minutes on Sunday morning. They're uncommitted. They're just drifters. Because they have never discovered their importance, number one. Number two, their purpose in the kingdom. So when they don't understand their purpose, they always go to prayer. Now, Lord, I need you to help me with this. I need you to do this. Now, the sun's shining. All the solar system's going. And it's happening because he will not lie. And it is his spoken word. It is his rhema word. And all the planets are doing their thing. And everything he designs doing their thing. And you're sitting here saying, I need you to do this for me. I need you to do this for me. And that's why some people's prayer life never has any depth to it. Because you go there with a mindset that I'm talking to Santa Claus. Am I preaching today? Hallelujah. God is insulted. And we just take for granted. Well, I showed up at the physical church building, not understanding this don't have any glorification. I could kick that thing down right now. It's not going to strike me dead. But when I lay my mouth on God's real church, which is you, you better know all God knows about people. Better know how to mete out justice. Hallelujah. I've got everybody's attention. Oh, hallelujah. I'm talking about the March of the Misfits. I have been in this for 55 years. I have seen people come and I have seen people go. I've seen 90-day wonders. And I've seen people that would die for this, that God raised up out of obscurity, that were nobodies. And he raised them up and created greatness in them. And they were in it for the long haul. Not just I'm feeling good right now and I'm on an emotional high. And brother, when you walk out the door, lust hits you square between the eyes. And you don't know how to defend yourself from it. So you just let your mind begin. You turn around and put that computer screen. I'm not preaching to you, brother. But you put that computer screen. It can be good. And it can make that television look like a backyard boys club. But when you feed God's headship with corruption, when you listen to corruption, you are trying to mix bitter water and sweet water together, because he is the head of the church. He said, present yourself a living sacrifice. You'll never take the prince of this community down. The flesh church will never survive. But when this church comes together, canceling out its own agenda, and say, I'm fixing to link up with my brother. I'm going to link up with my sister. We've got two different personalities. We've got two different outlooks on life. But we're about to come together where we need a pastor. We need a Moses. You need a Moses in your life. Don't sit and say, I just go where the Spirit leads. You're 1,600 miles wide and about a 1/16 of an inch deep. You're not that spiritual. I need to send you an alert. Wherever the Lord leads. No, why don't you just be straight up honest? My flesh don't want to submit to a pastor. And I don't want to get too invested, because it will mess up my personal plans and my personal ambitions. You got it right. Because they're going to be messed up. I used you in uniform last night. You can't go rogue. You might not look like what your authorities are saying, but you have to do what your authorities say. Why? Because the authority and the chain of authority, God is supreme authority. Lucifer is under God. Flesh is under Lucifer. That's why you're trying to deal with Lucifer in the flesh, and he's kicking, hiding, taking names. But when you're born of the water and of the spirit, when you're sold out, third power will be engrafted in first power, and you become heirs and joint heirs. The only way you're going to deal with Lucifer.
God help me, Jesus.
I'm dissatisfied, preacher. I'm nervous. There's some rumblings going on. I just don't like not being able to control my destiny. I don't like it. I don't like it. I like to control. I like to control the house. I like to control. I've got to have my sphere. I've got to have everything in order the way I want it done. And there ain't nobody going to penetrate that world. Oh, hallelujah. And even God will not penetrate it until it's laid down and say it's nothing but corruption. It's corruption. I want to come together with the entire body. It's not about my glorification. It's one for the team. It's one for the team. That's why when people are hopping around churches, going from to and fro, just always meandering. You don't want me to be too tough. But a thought some time ago came to me. If you're eating out of a pasture that God has not assigned you to, you liable to get food poisoning. He might have that church on a diet that he's not ready for you to be on yet. So when you take it upon yourself to move and pick up family, that the family's the one's going to be hurt. Selfish mama and selfish daddy need to get their mind off of being selfish and understand the repercussions. Hallelujah. It's not one size fits all. And when you rumble that thing and you go to using ignorance, and that's what we are. When you use ignorance to customize so I can feel better, so I know everything's going to be right, what you're doing is insulting God. That's holding the solar system up, saying you don't know about me and you don't know what I feel. That's as funny as a gnat eating a bell of hay. He knew you before you knew you. He knew your ups and downs, and he even knew you're going to be sitting right where you're sitting right now. Just like he knows where you're going to be in 30 minutes. And he's got an eye peeled on your heartbeat and your blood pressure. When he says, I've got a mission to do. You know why I'm relentless about this, Pastor? Now, some's going to say, that old Southern boy, he coming off cocky and smart aleck. No, I'm not. You ain't walked in my shoes. I have, even since 2011, I have told him. Because when the pressure comes on and disease starts eating on your wife and disease starts eating on your daughter and everything starts becoming uncomfortable, and then you stick your hands in the face of God and say, I have been faithful to you since I've been a teenager. I have done things that people in the church refuse to do. I've traveled without any money. I gave up the white picket fence dream. I gave up all of this to do your will. And this is what I get. I tell you what. Go after them. I'm done. I'm retiring. His attitude toward me, sir. Well, you ain't suffered enough, son. I know how to adjust your attitude. And your finances go to bonk. Everything goes to bonk. And you're just laying in a bed, can't get up, unmotivated, tired, sleepy all the time, depressed. Your chemicals out of balance. Your dopamine and serotonin levels are out of balance. And if you think them being out of balance is not going to affect your behavior, you have lost what little scruples God has given you. It's like you going out and taking one of these new automobiles and take that power pack out of there. All you've got is a beauty sitting here, but you try to crank it up. You try to get out on the interstate and do 75 miles an hour. The rest of that thing from GPS, I got one man, you can talk to that daddy rabbit. You can push a button going down the road and say, take me to Sirius Radio Channel. Bop, 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 bop. Thank you. Boom, boom, there it is. Woo, beauty, beauty. Outside, look at my cream puff. Yeah, beauty. But you take one of them power packs out of that thing that back blinker is depending on. The most insignificant part of that new vehicle, it's depending on that power pack. But when I take it out of the body of that vehicle, my brother, you say, why do you keep picking on me, Brother Lewis? Because I'm going to tell you, I was thinking this morning getting dressed. God has proven himself to both of you on several occasions in your lifetime. But he's got one more proven to you. And once you buy this one, you'll never look back. You'll never live with another regret. You'll say, I am thankful that I cut some things out of my life. And I'm not going to hobnob with it. I'm not going to let that, because it's bringing my spirit down. It's bringing the function of my body down. There's some people God spares me from, because they've not learned how to talk yet. Everything's blah. Everything's negative. And their body is getting all these signals. Break down, be negative. Don't sit there and look at me. Don't do that. You don't know how bad the dopamine levels and the chemicals in my head got messed up. Call my wife, she can tell you. Call my daughter that has cried over the past months saying, My daddy has returned. That anointing is upon him like never before. Hallelujah. She used to watch me in the Crusades laying hands on cancers and brain tumors and have documentation. And I was in a world of anointing and power. But then I start looking to the left and I start looking for approval on the right. And I start sitting there with him. Well, that can't be wrong. That can't. Man, and I start letting this thing, God put J in jealousy. Your wife didn't. Or your girlfriend didn't. God did. He said, you'll either serve me and take all of my kingdom benefits. You ain't gonna ride the fence. Little flesh, a little Holy Ghost. Little flesh, little Holy Ghost. It's all Holy Ghost or your flesh is in trouble. Hallelujah. David's misfits rallied around a common cause. That cause was to defeat. It wasn't to defeat my brother or my sister. It was to defeat the enemy, the real enemy. I said the real enemy. We have to stay focused. How do we do that? You can't do that with fleshly distractions in your life. He said, they that keep their mind stayed upon me shall be in perfect peace. Stay. Not take a vacation every now and then. Stayed. And then your body begins to react to God and His purpose and His plan. And you won't look around and see what you ain't got no more. And you won't feel insulted. And you won't feel intimidated. You won't have to go into a defensive posture. You ain't gonna hurt me again. You ain't gonna hurt me again. I don't care how much I pray. You ain't hurt me again. You ain't gonna hurt me again. God said, quit fighting that battle. Quit fighting that. That ain't even a battle that even amounts to a freckle on a frog's back. Because what they think about you is not what I think about you. They could all be against you, and I'm still for you. God don't consult your past to determine your future. He don't consult the former players in your life to determine how much He's going to anointing He's going to mete out to you. When can I get these things to work in my life? Right now. You can already be thinking of when I'm about to bring this altar call. You can already be thinking. Instead of saying, well, I'm going to stay back here when God's ready to come to me and do something for me. Oh, you'll shrivel up like a prune. You need to get in the press like the woman with the issue of blood. You need to lose your manners. You need to lose etiquette. Are you going to touch him? Oh, I don't know. Get out of my way. You going to praise him? I don't know. I don't know. Get out of my way. I'm going to hurt you. It's not about them. It's about him. Coming to a close. These misfits are rallied around a common cause. That cause was to defeat Saul and make David king. What changed these men? What changed these misfits? I'm going to say it again because that's a key word. What changed? Oh, I don't want to change. Man, I can't stand change. What changed these misfits was they all laid down their self-centered anger, easily offended ways. It's not about you. You're investing way too much in your ego. You hadn't hung on a cross. Calvary will not be a redo. You keep living in your past and keep dragging things you repented out from under the blood. You're going to stay in la-la land. Because God has spiritual amnesia. You're trying to remind Him in your prayers about things that were repented over. He simply does not know what you're talking about. And you're not going to make Him understand what you're talking about. He's not going back onto the blood. He said, they're as far as the east is from the west. Only humans record failures. They earmark you. And they remind you. But you ain't gonna blame it on Him. And you know what He's saying through me right now? let them earmark you. Come here, misfit. Come here. Why don't you sell out to my cause? They can't stop you. They can't stop a conscious decision. Happiness is a decision. There ain't nobody can make you unhappy if you determine to be happy. But you're using fleshly techniques to try to bring your happiness. Instead of musing on the Word of God that says, in His presence, there's fullness of joy. At His right hand of authority, there's pleasure forevermore. Musicians, come. We are fighting a common enemy. We have to stay focused on who we're attacking. Our attitude must change from watch your back to I've got your back. Some of you have had stuff and having stuff that is out to get you. Depression, suicide, addiction, and hurt are after you. Someone needs to fight for you. If you come together fitly joined as one army, one common cause, everybody gets to glory and celebrate. But when the church is pulling against each other, isolating themselves from each other, picking and choosing, the devil has rest. Please stay focused, everybody. Please. If we're going to see folks who are broken, devastated, and bitter, used up and feel like misfits to become all they're destined to become, then we must be willing to fight. Again, I'm looking at you because the illustration last night, you don't go out there on duty with your personal agenda. You take your marching orders. You don't think about yourself. You think of the team. Because this needs to be a fine oiled machine in this place. Where the fivefold ministry is working. The nine spiritual gifts are operating. And people are being changed. And people are being restored. And people are being healed. They ain't got time to spread gossip about each other. It ain't got time to fly all over town. The town needs to have an impression about those people on the side of that highway over there. There's something unique about them. There's something different about them. There's something. They are just a flowing machine. Flowing. The love of God is flowing. And we don't have to come, even on this platform, we don't have to come up here stressed out, tense. We don't have to perform in the pews and try to force worship, try to force a feeling. Instead of it letting be a natural artesian well just flowing out of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I've come to do what the book said. Jesus told Peter, he said, I have prayed that your faith fail not. He went on to say, he said, strengthen the brethren. And I've come to prop your arms up, to give a signal that though you are depressed and hurting and wounded in your own spirit, The congregation says, pastor says we're winning. I don't understand my current circumstances. I don't understand what God's trying to do with me. I'm frustrated, but I still love Him. I love His purpose. And there is power in unity. There is spiritual health in unity. A city, a house divided against itself cannot stand. The kids are out of sorts. The teenagers in the family are out of sorts. Everybody's hurting. They're sick. Everybody's discombobulated. And we're going to go to church and try to work it all up. We're frustrated. Do we really think that's what God's plan is? He said, I know from now on, Adam and Eve, because of your disobedience, because of your mentality, my people will be frail, fallen. But I've got to come and bring my spirit. Well, Lord, why didn't you just stop there and just bump them off and keep that utopia? Because he was in the heavenlies in a spirit form. God is a spirit, and they that worship him, it's never they, them, or there. It's always he, him, and his. He's jealous. He gets all glory. He told me a few years ago, says in Philippians, wherefore God hath highly exalted him, giving him a name. I know you're a son. Are you a physical father? Huh? But what's your name? What is your name? Jeff? No, I know. No problem. Jeff. Jeff, you're a son. Jeff, you're a father. At gospel, you incorporate in one body
all those attributes,
but you're still one. There ain't three Jeffs. Oh, I'm headed somewhere. You don't want to some fish head for you on the Holy Ghost. You ain't gonna want to miss it. Wherefore God hath highly exalted him, given him a name that is above every name. Am I in scripture? That at the name of Jesus, every knee's gonna bow. Everyone just confess. Name and name. But at the name of Jesus, your kingdom authority, your power, your optimal performance. If my knee bows at that name, then my sins have to bow at that name. Who hung on the cross? Jesus. Who was the Lamb that paid for my sin? What's your problem? Being baptized in that same name. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. What name? What name?
Jesus.
About to transform you.
Jesus.
Jesus. Keep saying.
Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
Who?
Jesus.
Who?
Jesus.
Who?
Jesus.
Talk to yourself. My stress, my anxiety. Jesus. Addictions. Jesus. Jesus. Look over at your pastor's wife and say, "Whoo, that's a beautiful name." That's a beautiful name. Why does people fight that name? Why take on offices that are nameless? I'm liable to show you in the Bible that Matthew 28 and 19 was not the original text. But Constantine and his minions changed it.
They sure did.
Go ye therefore. That was not the original text. Come on.
I like you, Jeff.
I like you too.
I'm not going to share my offering with you, but I like you.
That's all right.
I said, I like you, Jeff, because something's happening, Jeff, in the spirit world, Jeff, because he is totally invested in you, Jeff. And he said, tell my son, Jeff, tie a knot in the rope. Help is on the way. Is this okay? You said we're liable to come out, call out pizza today. My Lord have mercy. It's 12 high noon. High noon. And all of us Babdecostals are having a time in here right now. Everybody say, Jesus. Pronounce it. Jesus. Speak to your nerves that are got the heebie-jeebies right now. Jesus. No other name. He said, I'm a present help. I'm a present help. I'm being tempted right now. Jesus. I'm in depression right now. And I'm taking medication right now. Jesus. You say, are you putting that down? No, I just told you I'm taking medication. That don't make him any less Jesus for me. I thought he needed a straight jacket. Pastor's going to have to find better evangelists than that. My mama will tell you there ain't another one like me. I didn't say that was pro or con. I just said she said there ain't another one like me. So no, you can have all the evangelists, Prophet Tom, and everybody else, and I love old Tommy, baby. I met him. He had a word for me, did he not? I'm not shooting it. But he's got his own mission. He's got his own assignment. He's got his uniqueness. And I sure have mine. That's what church needs to be like. Loose. Everybody comes in tense. Man, they say one word to me, I'm going to slap them cross-sided. Come in with memory of their failures, and you can't even worship because you got their failures on your mind. But what about Jesus cleansing your mind and bringing you into one cause and one purpose? You know what he told me, Jeff? About Philippians, wherefore God hath highly exalted him, given him a name that is above every name. He told me years ago, he said, if I didn't want you baptizing in my name, I would have left him nameless. It's him that hung on the cross. Why am I ashamed to be baptized in his name? It was him that paid the price. Why am I ashamed of that? I brag about that. That's where my power, First Lady, that's where my power comes. That's where my deliverance comes. That's where my joy comes. I boast about that name. I said, I boast about that name. Loose. In Jesus' name, clear up all the fogginess, clear up the cobwebs, loose fullness of joy on her. Everybody say the march of the misfit. God never asked you to be normal. God called you to be different. The unqualified of God have been called to fit in anyway. They are the ones man overlooks, but God notices and plucks them from obscurity. Our identity must not be determined by what the world says about us, but by the fact that God dwells in us. Throughout history, God has always used the least likely and the most unqualified to provoke change. Those who usually lost out on man's approval, but always won with God's dreamed vision. When people don't understand the supernatural power of God, they always put God's vessels on trial to defend what they've never experienced. God loves misfits. It is time to quit consulting your past to find your future. This is a new day. Everybody talk to your body right now and you're going to see. This is a new day. Say it. Verbalize it. Verbalize it. When you get up in the day, verbalize it. And see if your body don't start responding to it. Become repetitious. This is a great day. This is a great day of opportunities. This is a great day. And watch your body begin to function to it. I'm not jihawing with you. I'm telling you the fact. Or if you don't want to try that, try this. Oh, I'm a failure. Oh, I'm a failure. I'm a failure. I'm a loser. I'm a loser. My Lord, I'm a loser, 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 loser. And watch your body respond to it. Christ in you. Who in me? Christ in me. The hope. Hope. We're doing good, Pastor. I'm feeling it. We're doing good. A little lengthy, but we're doing good. We're doing real good. I'm going to ask you, because I've been on your side as of last October. I was on your side of the spectrum. Packing my lunch when I come home from work. Getting up at 3:45. going and working all day. Hot. Go back home. Seemed like that was all my life. Just work and sleep. I was discombobulated, sis. What? Look at my wife, sick, struggling, crying, feeling hopeless, helpless. And then on top of that, then you get the word that your daughter has got endometrial carcinoma cancer in her female organs. God, I look at my little granddaughter where the odds were already against her in the generational curse. I'm pausing because I'm bridling my mouth right now. Oh, and I could tell you, and you say, wow, I'm going through that. How did she navigate through that? I'll tell you how she's navigating through it. Being raised by a single parent, and I sat down with my family just several weeks ago at my kitchen table, and I said, everybody listen up. Our friends in the Houston area that used to talk in tongues just like we are. I cannot do it. I tried it, and I become miserable because I didn't fit in. God rebuked me. He said, you keep looking toward man for your financial support and man for your happiness. He said, I called you. I made you unto myself. And I looked them all in the face and it amazed me, sis. My 10-year-old granddaughter sitting at the kitchen table. And I promise you, I want everybody to see this. Tears started flowing down her face. I said, your papa might not live long. There's no guarantees. I said, your nana might not live much longer. But you better hear me, Britton Alexander K. McCool. You better hear me. I am leaving you a legacy of the apostles' doctrine. I am leaving you a legacy of the name of Jesus, water baptism. I know I'm on live streaming right now. That baby took my heart out and she just squeezed it. She said, Papa, I want my daddy saved. Life is a teacher. You don't conquer life. All you do is learn from life. Sister, I'm speaking a word to you right now. There in the pink with the tears in your eyes. You don't conquer life. You learn from it. And then holding his hand. Have you ever read the word where it says God walked with Adam? And yet God was not even in flesh. How did he walk with him? His spirit was in him. Just like his spirit is in you. In you. In you. In you. In you. Don't be a false commercial. Radiate his beauty, not your flesh. Anybody learning anything? My daughter's looking at me and I said, Brittany Kay, from the time you was born, you was dedicated for the ministry. The anointing of God and your daddy's anointing is upon you. If this earthly thing is all over with, the show must go on. But it's going on in the right way. You don't have to gravitate to these people that ain't got the guts God gave a gnat to stand up for the doctrine. When you mention doctrine in your circles, they don't even know what you're talking about. All they know is jump, jump, jump. Man, that's supposed to mean you got something. But what are you going to do when your children are strung out on drugs? Can't keep them out of trouble.
You don't feel like all that.
You better have a relationship. You better be able to draw from the word. You better be able to live by the principles. Though that the hounds of hell are barking around my bedside, I shall not be moved. Heal these emotions. Heal this mind. Heal this heart. You notice where I got my hands, and I'm going to say it again so you can understand. When God's talking about the heart pumping in your physical body, He's talking about the very heart of His essence, the very heart of His being. He is the chief cornerstone. He is the head of the body, the church. Heal this very heart. Stay focused, my daughter. Stay focused. Stay focused on the more weightier things, the more important things. On the left and on the right, those things will fade away. They're just but for the moment. It too shall pass. In due time. But the weightier matters was birthed at a young age in a deep relationship. Some of you are getting aggravated with me. I can feel it in my spirit. Because we don't like to hear the word doctrine, doctrine, doctrine. That means we've got to buckle down, buckle down. I don't want to buckle down. You hear what I'm telling you. You will never conquer the prince of this city. Compromising the weightier things. Do not make provision for your next failure. You feeling it, brother? How many would say, Brother Lewis, over this past hour or so, you have spoke truth, because I know for a fact I have been in the fight of my physical life. A lot of drama going on. There's a lot of chaos going on. A lot of cheap talk going on. And it ain't doing nothing but plucking this vineyard. God said, return. Return to what made you unique. Return to what made you set apart. That's where the impact is going to come from all the other churches. Because they come a dime a dozen on every street corner. But what will make this church unique is they have finally had a funeral for their flesh. And we have united together. We have discovered our common enemy. I really do. I want to shut it down and cut you loose. Something's going on. Something's going on. And while I got you here, because I know there's only Sunday morning people, it's not just here, it's everywhere. We're living in a time where people they're not loyal to God. They're just flighty. They're more worried about themselves in pain and hurting. I am asking this church in the name that is above every name. You don't want to miss these next several services because I'm not here for the long haul. But this mission must go on. And this mission must be accomplished. But it's not going to be accomplished until all heads come together. Those that are interested, you have absolutely nothing to lose. You got everything to gain. Don't hang out in the pews acting bashful backwards. I said lose your etiquette. If you're buying into what I've preached here today, front and center, up, toes up against them stairs, spaced, come now. They ought to be running. It's what I'm talking about. People just... God's about to dump something out. I'm not here to talk about past. I'm here to deal with the present and the future. Hallelujah. Something special, brother's about to transpire. Your hands are about to get clammy. Please listen to me. I want to help you. Lord, I ask that all pride be crucified around this altar right now. Pride must come down in the name of Jesus. Egos must be canceled out in the name of Jesus. Victim's mentality must be cast down in the name of Jesus. I'm always the victim. I cast it down in the name of Jesus. When you feel that, respond in kind to the Holy Ghost. That's it. That's it, Frank. Go ahead. Tature paransa kum shakatai. That's it. Let it start coming up. A little trickle of water's coming up out of your belly. It ain't going to be long, and it's going to be a full artesian coming up out of you. You say, why ain't you laying hands on me? Because I want pride, ego. I want victim's mentality. I want it crucified. I want it crushed. Then the supernatural's about to hit you after it's gone. This thing is not about you. It's about God being glorified in you. It's about resurrection power coming up in you. All right, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Hands up. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. Hands up. Hands up. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. The utterance comes out of your belly. Raise your hands and receive ye the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Behold, I will do a new thing in you. I will do a new thing. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let it go, sis. Let it go. Don't worry about anything. Let it go and let God. Come on, church. You don't need a choir director up here. We just need somebody to get lost in the afterglow. We just need one spark and this thing will roll. There we go, sis. Yeah. Receive that supernatural blessing. Yay! Hallelujah! That's it. Hallelujah. That's it. Yes. Healing flow. Flow in Jesus' name. Some are still afraid to let it go. You say, well, what do you want me to do? I want you to respond just like he's standing in front of you. This is where the war is. This is where it's won and lost, right here. Right where my hand's at. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want Holy Ghost energy to be transmitted. Holy Ghost energy. Yadaba. I am praying for wholeness right now. I am praying for complete wholeness right now. In the name of Jesus, from the top of his physical head down to the soles of his physical feet, I am asking for Holy Ghost energy. Flow! Jesus! 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 That's where that... God, right now, it has to be a corporate thing. It cannot be an individual. It's got to be a corporate thing. Lord, I am reaching out. I'm not holding back. Hallelujah. I am reaching out right now. Do not look to one. Hallelujah. Look to him. Hallelujah. Do not look to the natural. Look for the spiritual. Loose this man, Lord. Loose him. Loose his life. Loose his mind. Loose his spirit. And let there be a metamorphosis. That's it. Speak that out. That's it. Go ahead. Speak that out. Speak that out. Speak that out. Brother, you concur with what the Lord has said through his word. Now began to receive understanding. To be able to communicate with him of how to pray for it. Don't become rushed. Don't become frustrated because it's not happening fast enough. Flow with him. Hallelujah. Because the possibilities, Pastor, the potential is there for him to become a viral warrior. A viral, that's the word that comes, a viral. Warrior that is committed to the vision of this church and will fight in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. God elevates because he does it with favor and with blessing. And with acceptance. Somebody say in Jesus' name. I'm asking you once again when Pastor comes. Please. Please. Don't use God as an afterthought. Make his purpose in your life priority. Don't miss these services. You are going to hear from him. It will be earth-shaking from your standpoint. Life-changing from your standpoint. you will go forth in unity, locked, fitly joined together, not numbers, not quantity, but quality. Quit gawking at numbers. A successful person causes one to begin to bear fruit. That's a success. Lord, I'm just a human being. I want to be a conduit right now. I want you to become a bridge over troubled water. God, we are human and we cannot help ourselves, but we have ultimate confidence in you. We have total trust in you, Lord. You said, cast all your care upon him, for he careth for you. In Jesus. Build. Emotions, nerves, peace be still. Let the God of all glory be exalted within her. My God, Jesus, help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. I tremble at your presence, O Lord. Oh. He's a healing Jesus. Turmoil has left. Fear is gone. The blood of Jesus is upon your house. Intimidation is gone. Panic is gone. Gone in the name of Jesus. The Son of Righteousness is arising. A new moment. A new moment. A brand new moment. A supernatural event. It's happening right now in the name of Jesus. A soft answer turneth away wrath. The healing has begun. It has begun. Take baby steps. Everybody, care how long have you had the Holy Ghost, take baby steps. Start prophesying to yourself. I'm winning. I'm winning. I trust you, Lord. I trust you, Lord. I'm confident, Lord, in your plans. But I feel totally uncertain in my own plans. I'm confident in your plans. I'm confident in your plans, Lord. The healing, First Lady, has begun. Don't overanalyze. Flow. Don't start looking at the end game yet. Take the moment in. Little steps, little things. And God, some of you are going to have a nature change. Your response to people is going that abrupt, that rough tone, that matter of fact. It's going to change. Baby steps. Ain't that what the book says? That's your reasonable service. That's your reasonable service. Come on, Pastor. I love you, buddy. Look at your neighbor and say, we're in this thing together. Now look back at him and say, I've got your back. Because when one hurts in unity, everybody hurts.
Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says no man comes to God except the Spirit call him and bid him, right? So we haven't really advertised this as out. We haven't put it in the papers. It's on Facebook, on our Facebook page, and it's been word of mouth. So we're just going to pray. We're going to pray the Spirit draws in who needs to be here and get what they need from the Lord. Amen? Amen. So we're going to do that right now. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we gather together as assembly in the only name under heaven given among men whereby we can be saved, the name of Jesus. And Lord, we command the Spirit of the Lord now to begin to move the work of your hands, God. Draw on hearts and lives. You know who needs to be here. You know the fresh bread of the Holy Ghost that the man of God is carrying to deliver to this people and this congregation, Lord, over the next few days. So we pray, God, that you would touch the backsliders in the name of Jesus. We pray, Lord, that you would touch those that have once tasted of the glory and have said in heavenly places that they will find themselves drawn back to this house, Lord, for one more feeding in the name of Jesus. Those that have been bound by sin, deliver them in the name of the Lord. Those that are, Lord, shackled by the chains of sin, set them free in the name of Jesus. We pray for those people that have never experienced your Spirit in their lives, that you have talked to them. They have been created. The book says, Isaiah 43 says, they have been created for your glory. So, Lord, we pray that they will come and find your glory this week in the name of Jesus. We may not know their names. We may not see their faces. But, Lord, today we pray for them right now in the name of the Lord. Let the hand of the Lord and the angels of the Lord do the bidding of the word of the Lord right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Bring in those people that you've been talking to. Bring in the hungry and the thirsty. Bring in the destitute, the blind, and the lame. God, bring them in, those that are needing an operation in their spirit, man. And God, we just pray it right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Binding together and believing. You said, Lord, whatever we bind in heaven on earth would be bound in heaven. And Lord, you said whatever we loosed on earth would be loosed in heaven. So Lord, we stand upon your word, declaring and proclaiming it right now in Jesus' name. And somebody said amen. Amen. And somebody give him a little praise now. Hallelujah. La Mayeto Lomo Shana Mama Haya. Lord, hallelujah. 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 One thing, being pastor here, my wife and I, we kind of know a lot of things that are going on. Sometimes we don't know things that are going on, the Lord tells us. But we also know things that are going on that a lot of people don't know. And I just want to tell you that when Brother Lewis turned to Danny and Carlita and spoke that word, that was right on. Brother Jeff, didn't he say new nerves? Brother Jeff injured his hand. The Lord's given him new nerves in that hand. Isn't that what he said? He was praying about the nerves. You see, God knows what's happening. God's in control. I'm not going to keep you long. I think the Baptists are probably cleared out from Ponderosa now. Safe for us to go. Amen. Listen, when you leave, would you pick up the trash where you're sitting? Because we're going to have church tonight. Brother Pete is faithful. He goes through here with a trash can, picking everything up. But if you can help him, let's pick this place up real fast. Go get something to eat. Come back at 6 o'clock tonight. Amen. Bring somebody with you. Call somebody. Text somebody and say, you need to be in church with me tonight. Amen.